In today's KCRA3 Health Watch, looking ahead to February and Heart Health Month, the American Heart Association has some things that can help you prevent heart disease. And one of the leading experts on preventative cardiovascular disease, Dr. Joe Keenan, joins us now with more. And we have all these staples here on our table, Dr. Keenan. I was asking, you know, what's the difference between this and anything else I got in my fridge or my pantry? Bread, sure. Cheese, milk?
Well, the good news and what is new is these are fortified with plant sterols. Now, plant sterols, not a lot of folks know about this, but they're present in all of the foods that we have that come from plant sources, but not in enough to lower your cholesterol. But when food scientists have fortified some of these everyday foods, cheese, there's even an orange juice, there are muffins, and so on, two servings a day of these foods can lower your cholesterol up to 15%. That's the bad cholesterol.
That's amazing.
It's almost a drug effect. It's a very, very nice effect. And about half of us with bad cholesterol can get close to our goal with just eating two servings of these foods a day.
So basically, you need to look on the labels on each of these packages. It says something like coral-wise on the bread. It also has the heart-healthy label on the milk and the cheese saying it reduces your cholesterol. So make sure to look at the branding and the packaging so that you get this.
The website CoralWise has all of these products. There are new products coming online all the time. So what's nice is they're very easy to work into your everyday diet.
Mm-hmm. Especially cheese, milk, bread. We all eat that, right?
And if you're on the run, you can take a vitamin with you.
Right. Vitamins always very good for you. Tell us about overeating. One of the things that we were talking about in the commercial break.
Right.
Overeating once or 1 or 2 months straight is going to affect
well,
your
heart? Well, it's timely because Super Bowl weekend is when people overeat the most. We have the most calories consumed that day. But overeating basically throws the balance in your body of taking cholesterol out of tissues versus putting them in. And so you want to have moderation in your eating. We've just come through the holiday season. All of us have had a little indiscretion here and there.
Just a little bit. Yeah, so we want to be careful about that. What about exercise? Anything
well,
on the front of
course,
exercise?
Well, of course, exercise is beneficial in about three different ways. It actually raises the good cholesterol, the HDL. It actually makes insulin work better in your body, so it actually changes a lot of the metabolic profiles in your body. It helps you keep your weight down, and for a lot of us, it's a great stress reducer.
That's true. That's absolutely true. And then what age should we start considering our heart healthiness? I was telling you that I keep a bottle of vitamins now next to my computer just to remind myself to take them, but how old should we be when we really
well,
have to be concerned?
This is also new. We've discovered now that the disease begins in early childhood, so if there's a family history of heart disease, you should actually check your children at age 2 to see what their cholesterol level is.
Wow.
Because it's a long lifetime of building up plaque in the arteries, and we know now that if you start early, you can prevent this.
All right, Dr. Joe Keenan, thank you so much for joining
us.
And we have that information about heart healthiness on our website. We've linked hearthub.org. You can also check out the coralwise.com website for more information on these great foods.